listen, it here. Can we like write down the course of action? Like, do we have any lore masters in chat on how this went? It's a very like confusing timeline. So basically, it all starts with, let's go back to the beginning. Wantep pisses off Greek, right? Greek gets mad and goes nuts. Everyone shits on Greek. Greek tweets, I'm going to call him Greek now, tweets, gets 200 likes and 300 comments. All right, so what happened after that? Greek gets banned. Nobody cares. All right, so that's act one, scene one. What happened after that? Suryab got banned. All order gets destroyed on Twitch. Now what happened, chat? What happened after E-Rob got banned? There's so much to go through. I want to like try to summarize this to make sure that everyone's on the same page, because I'm honestly not. D-Kane asks Soda a bunch of drama baiting questions, right? Smart for D-Kane, five head by him, to ask drama baiting questions to make Soda say shit to make their podcast grow. And there's so much drama that I can't even, it's actually crazy.
That whole spiel, I said, yeah, I told them.
Okay, so let's go to the basics. You know what? LSF is a problem. I'll say it right now. This is a fucking issue, okay? The fact that this clip was not, the moderators did not say, hey, this is a clickbait clip, and they let it up there for a whole day and a half, is a problem. Like, the fact that this clip was there in the first place is an issue. Why didn't the mods take this clip down? It was clear bait, and it made everyone jump on the bandwagon of hating XQC. They're not stupid. They knew that this clip, if they left it up, is going to cause drama. And it did.
Don't have time to take off an entire week. That's no secret. All my viewers know I have hours I have to make up. And also, right. Wrath is coming out. So I told him way before, hey, I'm not going. Sorry. Like, I want to say, like, months before.
I really like Chance on a podcast. That's just a side note. I actually really would, I would watch Chance do a podcast. I like when he talks like this for some reason.
I just don't have time to take off an entire week. That's no secret. All my viewers know I have hours I have to make up.
Right.
And also, Wrath is coming out. So I told him way before, hey, I'm not going. Right.
So Chance said this. Chance said he is not going and told XQC that he's not going. Is what you think it should say. But this is the thing. This isn't what happened. Chance said that he told them, which is Cutie Cinderella, that he's not going. Which then, this is the problem. If you watch past this clip and you watch even before it a little bit, he's clearly talking about Cutie Cinderella. In fact, I can tell you he's talking about Cutie Cinderella because he told me this months ago that he told Cutie Cinderella that he's not going because of Wrath of Lich King. Like, it's exactly what Chance said. He told Cutie that he's not going way before, right? Way before. All Chance said was that XQC not going at the last minute is cringe. So that's what happened. Then the drama starts. This is where everything goes bonkers. Chance said that he told them Cutie was not going. XQC reacted to the clip. By the way, when I'm typing this, if you want to link me the clip so we can go through it, so I can understand the chronological order of everything. And tell me if I'm wrong on this. XC reacted to the clip, right? And he got baited by one guy. And I can't blame XQC for getting baited, by the way. Because the clip title, the clip everything, was fucking pure bait and bullshit. Again, Livestream Fails should have made sure that shit was down. The fact that that was a clip, all those comments, guess what? I would do the same damn thing. I would do the same thing as XQC. I would get pissed, and I agree. I would somewhat feel like I'm in a corner getting attacked. I totally would. I would feel the same fucking way. It was stupid. The fact that was on there is dumb as shit. But look, there was tons of hate for XQC. Everyone's fucking shitting on the guy, saying, go fuck yourself, he's a piece of shit, blah, 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 should have went to shit camp. Then XQC comes out, and it's like, he leaks DMs from Soda.
I don't get it. To say like months before, but he just suddenly didn't go. That was weird. Like, but it wouldn't be the.
I don't know where I heard it, but I heard someone just say that he said, "Oh, Soda's not going. Nah, I don't want to go anymore," or something.
And it, in my opinion, it is wrong for him to have done that.
Mm-hmm.
But also,
Northern Lion does fit into this. I will get to that.
So, it is like the 50th time that he's done it. So it comes a point where it's like, you know what? Never expect him to be fucking anywhere he says he's going to be. Like, fool me once, shame on you, fool me twice, whatever. What is that saying?
What is fool me the a millionth time, Chad? Which one's that?
Right? So
can't get fooled again.
Whatever the hell it was, that's right? The saying. And it's like, it's not like it's two times. I can think of like five off the top of my head. And you.
Okay. Also, I also said that I'm sorry for scapegoating you, which I feel bad for. It's not what I. At first, I kind of made it like a joke. But then I was like, oh, like people are taking a bite. Now I have to double down. So I did.
By the way, for anyone that's wondering if me and XQC are cool, I will say this. Ready? And I truly mean this. Chat, I just don't care about so much shit, man. I'm the kind of guy that if I get into a fight with you, I don't care in about 3 hours. I just don't give a shit. And people are like, I saw on live show comments, they're like, Mish should hold grudges longer. The fuck? I should get mad for a long period of time and hold resentment for what? For what? Who cares? After like, it does not matter. It's a ADHD is a blessing and a curse.
I double down. I said I would stop that like that skit, and I said I'd do something else instead.
Yeah, I forgot. So XQC leaks the things being like, and it's this huge drama. Soda said Fall Guys is cringe, which means OTK is not getting sponsored by Fall Guys anytime soon, and we're not getting our skin, which is kind of depressing.
I forgot. I said, oh, if he's not going, I'm not going, right? And then people got mad about that, so I had to commit then, because I was like, well, I kind of have to. What? And so I committed to that. But that was, at first I was like, guys, people say, oh, it's a joke, whatever. Guys, I said that in Soto's chat as like a whatever. I was baiting him to tell me if it was going or not. People that were in chat remember. I said that in chat as I said.
Hold on, we need closed captions for this.
Yo, bro, we come in LA, man. If you're not going, I'm not going, haha. Type shit. After that, people took the bait, and then everything got really weird. So then I doubled down and was like, "Fuck it." And then I apologized for skimboarding him because I thought it was wrong.
Okay, so he skimboarded Chance.
Either, which is fine. He's playing well, whatever. No friends, Ark. Well, it's like I don't know why they're doing this though.
Okay, so he said that he has a lot to do, and he was right. So basically, he leaked the DMs with Chance, right? Leaks DMs with Chance. Chance never said anything, which then Chance goes live. Or then here's what happened. LSF realizes they fucked up and listened to one dude, and the LSF mods didn't remove the post and farmed a ton of drama by doing it. LSF then realized they were wrong and that they started the drama. It was wrong. And people in the comments were actually calling it out, being like, by the way, this post is about Cutie Cinderella, and it got downvoted to shit because people wanted to farm it because they're like, no, dude, this is drama. Stop trying to stop it. Basically, people were trying to halt the train, and the choo-choo, 20,000 people in LSF were all trying to farm it. So LSF realized they fucked up, blah, 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 and they started the drama. So I'm here. This is where I kind of stopped watching Game of Thrones, right? What the fuck happened after this, chap? What the hell? I get up to here. I'm like, I. What the fuck happened after this? Okay, so.
Yeah, it was.
Here's what happens before all this. I actually remember weird. Now.
I mean,
this is where XQC felt like he was backed up in a corner and said he broke up with Adept. Yes. So this is what happened. He felt like he was backed up into a corner and he broke up with Adept. Like, that's what he said, right? He's like, you know what? Everyone's attacking me and all this shit. The reason why I didn't go to shit camp was because me and Adept broke up. And I kind of thought that'd be the end of it. And to be honest with you, I wasn't even going to react to this stuff because I kind of was like, all right, I feel like that's enough. Like, I'm not going to, like, you know, put my 2 cents into this. That's just a shitty situation, right? But then, I remember.
If I went to the event with Sammy.
Chat, you're getting good.
Weird. And then she felt like if I leaked stuff, then people would go against her. So I tried to protect her. And I feel like she has to be protected because she didn't do anything wrong. Sammy wasn't wrong at any given point. And I don't.
I'm pretty much just like Jake Lucky right now.
To get some backlash, so I couldn't leak anything or say anything. And I thought saying it privately to some individuals over there, they would understand that to like play around it and navigate around it all the better. But then they didn't. And then kind of buddy kind of jumped on me. And I was like, I can tank some hatred because I'm okay. Because a lot of this is my fault, you know? It's my family, you know? It's my side of the relationship. So if things fail because of my side of the stuff, well, then it's my fault. And it is my fault. And I take full responsibility for that. Sometimes that's just how it's.
So XQC said all this on his stream. He basically said he had to choose between Adept or he had to choose between his family. Now, I don't know any of this stuff, chat. And I think no one's really going to know this side of the story with like the family stuff. And I hope no one knows it. I hope none of that. So, okay, so XQC was live and pretty much said, like, I'm going to remove all this. He was backed up in a corner, said he broke up with Adept. He said it was family members, right? Said it was family things. Now, that's kind of where I thought it was going to end up, right? I thought that we all kind of thought that this was, like, the end of the drama, right here. He said it was family things, blah, blah, blah. I don't want to get involved with someone's personal life like that, right? Like, XQC was, I probably felt like he was backed up into a corner. I wasn't going to comment on this at all, because, like, this is not kind of my spot to talk until all this other shit happened. So he said it was family things. Now, here's what happened. I was up at the night when this happened. Adept is live. So XQC is ending his stream with like, what, 50, 60, 70,000 people, whatever it is. And Adept is live during this whole thing. And Adept, while she is live, goes up like 6,000 viewers of XQC Frogs saying shit. And now I was watching the chat. I'm going to be real with you. They were not, I would say like 80% of them were pretty nice, but 20% of them were pretty like, kind of like, fuck you. This is crazy, dude. So Adept goes up like 6,000 viewers and then Adept gets upset that he was live talking about it. Cause they wanted to try to, Adept wanted to try to just make this relationship. Basically, like, months would go by, and then they wouldn't talk about it, and then they would kind of bring it up, and it would go away, right? And this is where I really feel for XQC and Adept, because I know what it's like to have a public fucking relationship, right? I know what it's like. This shit's annoying as hell. Like, it is annoying as shit to have a public relationship. It's there's pros in it, right? Especially, you could work with each other really well. There's a lot of content you can make out of it, but it is a lot of pressure and it sucks. And if the inevitable happens, which is you guys break up, it is brutal. So then Adept, it's really city. Adept gets clipped to LSF like crazy. Adept gets attacked. Now I'm gonna say this, and this is not XQC's fault, it's just the fucking truth. Adept, XQC, even someone like me, right? But especially like XQC, because XQC is double my size. XQC could do something completely wrong, and Adept could be completely right, and they will find a way to make it seem like Adept was completely wrong. Or Adept was, yeah, they would. Because it's just how it works. Adept has an army of like 500 people, you're going up against 50 fucking thousand. It's not gonna end well. It's not gonna happen. Went on a 3-hour rant after she was done with the game. Blindsided by people talking about your relationship, you then go on live stream fails and see people shitting on you and saying like lol, like -1 Tesla, all that shit. Like, it's not easy, I'm sure. So she just kept talking for 3 hours. She was stressed. I'm sure she was stressed and tense. And I want people to kind of like try to put themselves in the shoes of either XQC or Adept, because both of the situations suck. Basically, XQC goes live after Emmy's tournament for League of Legends, and he reacts to her VOD, Adept talking for 3 hours.
We have to cut the bread somehow. You knew that I've always wanted, when things are moving on, to move on. You know how I am, okay? I don't cut it halfway. I have to go all the way. I don't have any things above my head all fucking day.
I can't do this with you anymore. You are not a victim, okay, here. You have never been a...
Okay, so XQC starts watching the VOD. Adept sees him watching the VOD. Adept calls XQC, and they have like 120 to 130,000 fucking people watching him do this shit. And Adept gets extremely upset. Here's the actual opinion I have about this whole thing. And it's just the fucking truth. It's exactly what Nick said. It's just fucking sad. Like, I feel like I see people trying to go after XQC, and I see people trying to go after Adept, right? But here's the thing. I feel like neither of them are in the right or wrong, because none of you have the full... you guys don't know anything. I mean, like, none of us do. We don't know the relationship that they've had for 6 years and all the things that have happened. We don't know anything about their family. I don't want to know anything about their family. And then they pretty much went on a rant for, like, an hour. And I'm going to be honest with you, it just felt like, I don't know how to explain it. It just felt like I shouldn't have been there. You know what I mean? I had to keep watching because it was so damn entertaining. But, like, I should not have been there. XQC calls Adept on stream to talk about it. They talk about the drama. Emeru is still doing her tournament despite all the drama happening. And then XQC goes to 120,000 viewers talking about the drama. XQC runs a 3-minute ad, gets 700 Twitch primes and 9 tier 1s. Okay, here's the thing. We're all just chilling there. The drama happened. It's kind of like it's all over, right? This is where it keeps going, chat. It just keeps going. XQC and them talk for an hour. I'm not fucking watching that shit. Fuck that shit. While we're just chilling, me and the boys, right? It's boys' night. Me, Aiden, and Kai. All of a sudden, you know, we're hanging out. The drama's kind of hopefully over at this point. You think it's all over. You think it's over, right? It's a two-day ordeal. And then this happens.
Uh-oh.
What do you say? Let's see, Kai.
Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, shit.
Yo.
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 I'm putting it up right now. Yo.
I love how the chat's saying, yo.
Dude, that's crazy. Yo. Holding your ex-girlfriend hostage for with an audience that loves to hate women. Responsible and nice. Where I'm from, we don't sell, but we like cowards. Why did you invite me to your events 2 years in a row if you thought I was a woman hater? Why?
So this is where it gets wild, right? So I don't even want to, I don't even care about, God damn it, I hate that I'm on LSF, but fuck, I don't know, what am I supposed to do in this situation? It's like, there's a cherry pie right in front of me, okay? Like, what am I supposed to do, not eat it? I'm a fat fuck. Shit goes bonkers.
I wasn't even talking about Judy, but I saw her tweet then.
Turn the glove in.
Bro. I thought the greatest use of the platform was Gamba, but now it's this. I guess I'm not doing myself. I guess I do worse than the worst every week, bro.
Bro, why did she delete the tweets, man? I had such funny comments under it.
I won't get no fuck, bro.
Nothing better than XQC. Okay, yo. I hate this fucking place. Billy Bob 123 1233, dude, go fuck yourself. All right. So Cutie tweets this. Is this the first time she tweets holding your ex-girlfriend hostage for Kanta with an audience that loves to hate women, responsible and nice? So she tweets that, and I'm pretty sure she deletes it immediately. She then tweets this. So XQC tweets bandwagoners, dog pilers, and ship jumpers. That's all there is on this platform around here. Absolute snakes everywhere, get a spine. Don't wait for the public opinion to lead the way to flip on someone. I would at you rats, but there's too many. So then I at myself, and I say, fucking do something with your life, you fat fucking loser. Which then I respond to myself, parasocial much? And Greek then says W. So this tweet is honestly absolutely terrible, but there's funnier ones. Where's the funny ones, chat? Cutie tweeted something so funny. I was cracking up by myself. I said, where is it? Does anyone have it? Okay, so Cutie basically tweeted out, she tweeted, grossest use of a platform I've ever seen. Which then I responded with, I thought you were talking about your podcast. So that was basically the joke, and it was funny. Which then she responds, wait, you don't like my podcast? I told you could react to it on stream. Good one, Cutie. I thought that was funny. Because if you don't understand the joke, it's actually a really fucking good one. Cutie basically is making fun of XQC. Because remember when XQC 3 days ago shit on me for watching the podcast on stream. And I it was funny. So XTC was on the call with Adept, and they were talking. And I go in Kai's chat because he's reacting to it. And I told him he can't react to this because it's Adept's podcast. But he didn't get the joke, and I just got a bunch of W's. Grossest use of a platform I've seen in a while. Okay, so this is it. Grossest use of a platform I've ever seen in a while. They went off on each other. Cutie basically started tweeting a bunch of shit, holding your ex-girlfriend hostage for content. Then XTC set quote tweets it and goes, "Where I come from, we don't subtweet like cowards. Why did you invite me to your events 2 years in a row if you thought I was a woman hater? Why platform me? How does it make any sense? Despicable behavior from this joke of a person." He @s Cutie Cinderella. Now, I thought I was getting the @. Here's the thing that I don't understand. I get why Cutie tweeted this. I don't get what XQC said. Why did you invite me to your events for 2 years in a row if you thought I was a woman hater? But that's not what she said. All she said was holding your ex-girlfriend hostage for content with an audience that loves to hate women, responsible and nice. That's not him saying, her saying that this guy's been a terrible human being for 2 years. You know what I mean? And maybe I just don't understand. How does it make any sense? Despicable behavior from this joke of a person. I mean, Cutie definitely inserted herself. Cutie definitely inserted herself. I feel like Cutie Cinderella saw a moment for clout. Of course. You don't tweet unless you want clout. Of course she tweeted and she wanted content and viewers. Cutie's farming this. Of course she is. She knows what she's doing. She inserted herself into the drama so she could start talking about it. That's literally what she did. She inserted herself in the drama so she could start talking about it. And she wanted to make a point, so she made her point, and she inserted herself into the drama. Does that not sound like a genius idea? And then she knows she's going to get hate. The cons are she knows that XQC viewers are going to attack her, but XQC viewers are going to watch her, and then she's going to run an ad. I know how it works. Trust me. She was sticking up for her friend. She was sticking up for her friend, but she tweeted it so that way people would see it, and she knew that she would get attacked, and then she knew that this whole thing she probably knew was going to exactly happen, for the most part. So she tweeted it, got a bunch of likes. Here's what happens. Cutie Cinderella and XQC keep going back at it. They start having this massive tweet drama war where they start subtweeting or quote tweeting. Then XQC tweets out something and he says this thing: "The bandwagoners, dogpilers, and ship jumpers, that's all there is on these platforms around here. Absolute snakes everywhere. Get a spine." Now, I get that, but what I'm very confused about with this one is he said, "Everyone can talk about their garbage, what I do, and how they feel about it. Everyone runs their mouth and they get support. Personal attacks went a little too hard here. Deleting this one out of respects for fellow peers." Was it about me? "Everyone could talk their garbage about what I do and how they feel about it. Everyone runs their mouth." So basically, XQC has a huge battle with Cutie Cinderella. It got deleted. And Cutie deleted all of her tweets as well. So I'm assuming they probably both had like a ceasefire, is what I'm guessing. Which then, they're all fighting. And while XQC's tweeting, Hassan then comments and says, "Keep posting through it, man." Jesus, dude. Oh, I have Hassan muted. 100. Bro, I'm sorry. I can't stand this shit. I love Hassan to death. I will follow him because I support him and I love Hassan. I can't stand the amount of times he tweets. I can't stand it. He tweets way too much. Like, what? Once every few days? Can't take it. Hassan says, "Keep posting through it, man." Which the next she says, "Brave of you to post on main and not on a third ult." "Offline chat or your plant seeds on your Discord. I'll give you that." Which basically, he was talking shit about Austin's show at that point. "You gonna take this?" Like, so he tweets at Hassan and says, "Brave of you to post on your main and the third offline chat is or your plant seeds in Discord." And then this XQC or Hassan says, "Go to sleep, little bro." And then XQC says, "You're not live, no can do." Ooh. Oh shit. Dang. XQC's on he's on his destiny arc. That's exactly what XQC is on.
XQC creates vertical relationships and believes his value is based off his viewership and then
Wait, Ludwig got on this or did Cutie Cinderella get on Ludwig's account?
XQC creates vertical relationships and believes his value is based off his viewership and then in return treats people like cogs to increase that or decrease that value. I know. And it's a really cynical and fucked up way to do shit. Which makes genuine friendships and communication impossible.
Holy shit. Oh, shit. Bro. Let's just draw the battle that's about to occur. You have XQC. Right here. Which, honestly, I made him look way stronger than he is. So you have XUC right here. You have Hassan right here. You have Ludwig. You have Cutie Cinderella. And then you have... Who else is up against XQC? And then you have Adept. And then where am I? I'm over here. I see the battle happening over there. I ain't going anywhere near... Here, let's draw NMP down here. This is Nick. He's got his hand over his hand. Like, yeah, let's draw the fence right here. This is Nick, okay? Nick is sitting on the fence right here. And I'm sitting on the fence right here with my camera, all right? Now, what could happen, and this is what I perceive is going to happen, is the Daliban is about to enter and join in reform with XQC because they see the light between XQC and the Daliban. And I think they are going to start to try to attack because they see that Hassan... Basically, what I'm saying is we need a new r/place, right? I feel like this is what I'm trying to get at. We need a new r/place. Things need to happen. Things need to happen. There's too much turmoil and there's too much drama that we need a new r/place. But that is absolutely insane. My whole thing on this... Look, I feel bad. I genuinely feel bad for everybody involved. I feel bad... The main person I feel bad for the most is Adept. Straight up, I feel about most bad for Adept. I think she got blindsided really hard. She's gonna get a ton of hate for all this shit. I could see that when she's trying to join, she's trying to make her points and stuff, but like it just... She's gonna get just tuned out because there's just too many viewers that are gonna side with XQC compared to what she's gonna say. Right? It's just what's going to happen. I feel bad for her. I feel bad for XQC. I feel bad for almost everybody. But at the same time, I kind of don't. Because they talked about it on stream from 120,000 people. Like, bro. You know, you wanted not to be aired, then don't go live. You know what I mean? Just, like, turn the mic off. If Cutie knew what she was doing, why'd she delete her tweet? Good question. Cutie deleted her tweet, I think, probably because she either A, talked to XQC, or B, she was just getting so much fucking hate, and she just had to get rid of it. You gotta realize something right now. Going after XQC, there is a solid 50 to 60,000 people who live and die by the guy. He has a very loyal fan base, right? And if you go after him right now, especially when everyone's dogpiling, you're gonna get probably death threats and a bunch of other shit that comes with it. Like, it's just gonna happen. It's gonna be fucking tough.